Hey everyone, welcome to this Unreal Engine 5 tutorial. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make a stamina system that you can basically attach to any character class as an actor component. So to give you an idea about what we'll be working on today, I'll show you how this works. So basically we've got a system where we can walk and sprint, and as we sprint, the stamina drains. But a problem I've seen with a lot of YouTube tutorials in creating a stamina system is that it's usually not very robust. And by that I mean, for example, if the player is holding down the shift key but not moving, the character's stamina drains. Or if the character bumps into a wall or an obstacle, the stamina keeps draining. But with the system I've implemented, you'll notice that if the character is not on the ground, or if they bump into an obstacle and they stop moving, then the system knows that she's no longer sprinting and begins to regenerate her stamina. And also, when the stamina gets completely depleted, the character becomes exhausted and she can no longer sprint until stamina regenerates completely. The tutorial will be divided up into three parts. In part one, we'll cover setting up a basic UI element so that we can get visual feedback of when the character's stamina drains or regenerates, creating the stamina actor component and attaching it to our third person character, setting up our initial character references, adding a sprint functionality to our character, and finally creating a start sprinting function and a stop sprinting function. If you'd like to get access to the project file for this YouTube tutorial, you can download the UE 5.4 project file completely for free from my Patreon. I'll provide a link in the video description. It's completely free. You don't need to sign up or anything. But with that overview out of the way, let's go through this step by step on how you can actually create this yourself. So right now I'm just using the standard third person template. So if you want to follow along, you can just create a brand new third person template and start from scratch. The only difference is that I've added my own character mesh to this blueprint. It's exactly the same blueprint character class that comes with the third person template. And all I've done is just add my own character mesh that I created. Now, the first thing that we're going to do is we're just going to create a very simple UI system so we can get a little feedback on the stamina draining and regenerating, because we will implement a few event dispatches in the actual component system itself, which we can bind to events in the UI. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to create a new folder and I'm just going to call it stamina content. And all the new content material I'll put into here just to keep it separated from the stock content that comes with the template. Now, I will first create a folder and just call it UI and double click on that. So I'm just going to right click in this empty space, go down to user interface, and then I'm going to select widget blueprint. And I'll just select the user widget base class here, and I'll call this WBP underscore stamina. Double click on that. And the first thing I'm going to add to this widget is just a size box. Just add it there. And then over here, I'm going to override the width and override the height. And for the width, I'll do 500 and the height, I'll do 50. And then you'll notice that it hasn't changed, but if you just want to go up here where it says fill screen, click on that and then click on desired on screen, and that'll reflect the size that you've specified. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add a horizontal box and just child it to the size box. I'm going to keep it really simple, so I'll just add now a text and child that to the horizontal box we've just added. And then with the text highlighted, come over here where the text input is located and just type in 100. And then we also want to make sure that we tick this box up here that says is variable. And this will mean that we'll be able to make changes to this at runtime using the blueprint graph. And next I'll add a progress bar, child that to the horizontal box as well. And then for this, I'll just click on fill so it fills up the entire scale there. And I might just add a little bit of padding to the left side, maybe 10. And the last thing we want to do for this progress bar is just come down here where it says percent and change it from 0 to 1, and that'll fill up the whole bar. So very, very simple, nothing fancy. Last thing we'll do though is just create a HUD class as well that we'll add this to. So if we go back to our stamina content UI folder, right click, go down to user interface again, and then select another widget blueprint, and then select user widget again. And this one we'll call WBP _HUD heads up display, and then just save that. Double click on that. And then for this one, we'll add a canvas panel. And then now what we'll do is we'll add the WBP stamina bar that we've just created as a child to the canvas panel. And then once you've dragged that in, click this little box here that says size to content. And then we will just drag it down to the corner a little bit here, just so it's not completely in the corner there. And it is anchored to the left corner of the screen, which is what we want. And then we'll compile and save that. Now that we've got that, we'll go into our content folder and then to the third person folder, blueprints, and then our third person character. And then off begin play, we will drag off a pin here and then type in create widget, enter. And we will select WBP _HUD, which we just created. And then we might as well promote this to a variable just in case you want to be able to use this later. And then rename that to HUD. And then finally, drag off from the HUD pin here and type in add to viewport. Compile and save. And now if we press play, we have our stamina progress bar up in the corner there. We don't have any functionality for the stamina system yet, so that's what we'll do now. So now that we've got some way of measuring our stamina in game, let's go back to our stamina content folder, and in here we're going to right click and create a new folder and call this components. And then inside here we're going to create a blueprint class. In here, we're going to select an actor component. And it says here, an actor component is a reusable component that can be added to any actor. Okay, so we'll select that and we'll call this BPC for blueprint component _stamina_system. And we'll double click that. Now, the first thing that we need to do here in our stamina system is that we need to set up some references to the character that owns it. Now, because an actor component can be added to multiple different characters or actors within a game, in order to run the logic within that component for a specific actor, it needs to know which actor is using it at any particular time. So the first thing that we're going to do is inside BPC stamina system is we're going to create a custom event. So right click and type in custom event, and we'll call this setup stamina component references. So the first reference that we'll need is a reference to the actor itself that owns it. With this custom event selected, we can go over here and press this create new input argument. And the type of input we want for this one is going to be an actor. So we type in actor and we scroll down to this one here under object types and then actor object reference. And we will call this just actor. So this will be a reference to the actual owner of this component. Now with the event highlighted again, we'll add another input. This time we need to get a reference to the actor's movement component. So if we go back to our third person character here, you'll notice that in this components window here, there's a character movement component here. So in order to find out what kind of input we need, we can just drag this out onto the event graph and then hover our mouse over here. And it says here it's called a character movement component object reference. Okay, so that's the type of input that we need back in our stamina system. So we select the drop down here and type in character movement component. There it is there. And we need the object reference. And we'll just call this character movement component. And the last reference we're going to create here is the speeds at which you want the character to be moving when they're walking and when they're sprinting. So to do this, I'm actually going to create a struct. So if we go back to our stamina content folder here, I'm going to right click, create a new folder and call this structs. Here we want to right click and we want to go to the drop down here that says blueprint and then select structure. And now a common naming convention for structs is just F underscore, and we'll call this movement speed. Enter and then save. Now, if you haven't used structs before, I'll give a quick introduction to it. So a struct is basically a container of different variables. You can have a number of different variables here, all of different types. You can even have a struct of other structs as well. But for this particular one, we're only going to need two variables. The first one is going to be a float. And we will name this variable walking. And our second variable is going to be a float as well. And we will name this sprinting. And then save. And then back in our stamina system here, what we can do is we can now add a new input argument here. And then from the dropdown, we're actually going to select this structure we just created. So I'm going to type in F underscore movement. And there we go. We've got that struct there. And then we'll name that movement speeds. Now, you might be wondering why I created a struct for movement speeds instead of just simply creating two different variables of type float, one for walking and one for sprinting. Well, the reason I've done it this way is because normally I would have many more different types of speeds. So for example, I might have one for crouching, I might have one for aiming down sights, I might have another one for maybe prone movement, swimming movement. And this is just a way to keep it all neat and tidy in one particular container where I can access all the different speeds. Okay, so now we've got our setup stamina component references event. Let's go back to the third person character and actually implement this off begin play. First thing we need to do is we actually have to add our component. So let's go over to the add button here and type in BPC underscore, and there it is there, the stamina system. Add, compile, save. And then I'm going to drag this node out into the event graph here, and I'm going to call this event that we just created. So if we drag off here and type in set up stamina component references, now it's going to call that event on begin play. So now, of course, we need to actually feed in the references that we need. So for the first one, we've got a reference to the actor itself. So we can just drag off there and type in get reference to self, and that is a reference to this particular blueprint class. The next reference we need is the character movement component, so we can go over here to our components, click on the character movement component, drag it out into the graph, and then connect it up to the character movement component input. And then finally, for movement speeds, all I'm going to do here is just right click split struct pin, and I'm going to manually input the speeds for each of these moving states. So for walking speed, we'll make it 230 centimeters per second. And for sprinting, we'll make it 500 centimeters per second. Okay. So that's that part done. Now, at the moment, this won't do anything because we're not actually doing anything with these events yet. So the first things first is we will set a reference to each of these as its own variable within the Blueprint class. And let's drag off actor and click promote to variable. And now we'll click drag off character movement component, promote to variable, and movement speeds, promote to variable. And I'll just reorganize these so that we have actor going first, and then character component second, and then movement component, movement speed third. Now, what I also want to do is I want to set the max walking speed for this actor when this event initializes. And we do that from the character movement component. So if we can drag off that and then type in set max walk speed. And again, I'll just reorganize this so that it comes after the movement speed variable here. And then what I'll do is from this movement speed variable we created, I'll just right click this output pin here and click split struct pin. And then we want the max walking speed to be set to the walking speed that we specified in our third person character. Compile and save, and I'm just going to clean this up a little bit. So the next thing that we need to do is we need to create an input action for our sprinting. So I'll go back to our stamina content folder here, right click, and I'll create a new folder and just call this input. Double click on that and then right click here and I'll go down to input and then input action, and I'll call this IA underscore sprint, save that. And then we'll go back to the folder, right click, go to input, and we'll create a new input mapping context as well. So IMC underscore sprint. So now that we've created the mapping context, we'll double click that and we'll add a new mapping, and we're going to select this drop down here and select IA sprint that we just created. And then we'll select the keyboard input here, and I'm going to press the left shift key. So now left shift is assigned as our input to start this sprint action. We'll save that. And then in our BPC stamina system off of begin play, we will add that mapping context. So I'm going to right click and type in get player controller. And then from the output pin, enhanced, get enhanced input local player subsystem. And then from that output, add mapping context. And we will hook that up to event begin play. And of course, we need to select the actual mapping context as well. So I'm going to select IMC sprint. Now, you might be wondering why I don't simply just add this input action to the mapping context that is already part of the third person character. And you certainly could do that. There's nothing particularly wrong with doing it either way. It's just the way that I'm doing it in this particular example, so that sprinting is actually added as a function of the stamina system. You certainly don't need to do that because you might have characters that can sprint but don't need a stamina component as well. So either way is perfectly fine. So I'm just going to save that. Comment out a few of these sections here. So add mapping context for sprint action. And I'll comment out this section as well. Set up initial references. Now that we've got our input action, we can add it to our graph. So we can either just simply drag the input action into the graph directly, or right click and type in IA underscore sprint and add it that way. And I'm just going to select the down arrow here. Now we need to add two functions. One is to start sprinting and another is to stop sprinting. So we need to add a little bit of functionality to that. So let's start with the start sprinting. So we'll go up to functions and click in add new function, and we'll call this start sprinting. And before we start sprinting, we actually need to check that the character is not exhausted. So an exhausted event will happen when stamina is completely drained, and that means that there will be a cooldown time before the character can sprint again. So we'll need to add that as a Boolean variable. So we'll go to variables here, add a new variable, call it isExhausted? And we'll change that to a Boolean type variable. And we'll make sure that the default is not true. So we'll leave that as it is. We'll drag that onto the graph, get is exhausted, and we'll drag off there and type in, we'll type in not Boolean. So the character is not exhausted. And then from the output of the not Boolean, we will type in branch and then hook that up. So if the character is not, if not exhausted is true, we can then move on to the next part of the logic. So what do we want the start sprinting function to do? Well, we wanted to set the max walk speed to the sprinting speed that we defined earlier. So we will get a reference to our character movement component and get the character movement component. And then from there, we will type in set max walk speed. And we'll hook that up to the true. And we need to get a reference to the movement speeds struct variable we created earlier. Get movement speeds, right click, split struct pin. And then we want our max walk speed to be set to our sprinting speed. So if the character is not exhausted, set max walk speed to sprinting. Then after that, we will add a new variable of type Boolean, and we will call it sprint action active. Compile and save, and we will drop that directly onto the pin, and we will click the active checkbox there. And then from there, what do we want the function to do? Well, we want it to start to drain our stamina. So what we'll do is we'll go back to the event graph and we'll just add a custom event. And we will call this start stamina cycle. We'll handle the logic for that event in a moment, but for now, we'll just go back to our function, our start sprinting function, and call that event. Start stamina cycle. So once we start sprinting, we will call that event. So that's a start sprinting logic done. Now we'll go back to our event graph and then drag off start sprinting onto our event graph and then hook it up to started on our input action. So now if we press play, now we have a sprint speed. Of course, even if we do take our finger off the left shift key, the character is still sprinting because we need to create a stop sprinting function as well. So we'll do that now. So we'll go over to functions and type in stop sprinting. And then from here, very simple, we just drag off a reference to our character movement component and select get and set max walk speed. Hook that up. And we will get another reference to our speed struct again, right click, split struct pin, and this time we'll hook it up to the walking speed. And now we will get our sprint action active Boolean, hook that up to the pin. Whoops, what's happened there? Hook it up to the pin and then leave that unchecked. And now we need to create a new custom event in our stamina system event graph. And we'll call it stopped sprinting. Just compile and save. Go back to our function and then call that event stopped sprinting. Now we'll close that, go back to our event graph and then drag off our stop sprinting function and then hook that up to completed. So now when we take our finger off the left shift key, we're going to execute the stop sprinting function, which will set our speed back to walking. So if we press play. And we're walking, sprinting, walking, sprinting, and that's all working fine. So just to recap what we've completed in part one of this tutorial, first we set up a basic UI element and added it to our viewport. Then we created an actor component for our stamina system, set up the initial character references. We added a sprint ability to our character. And finally, we added a start sprinting function and a stop sprinting function. In the next part of this tutorial, we'll set up the stamina drain and stamina regenerate functions. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please like the video and consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.